Now, friends, let us discuss about your B part where important chapters are there. So, even from here, questions are asked. The percentage, the weightage is also given here. First is time of supply. Now, time of supply is a chapter which is very important, but you will not see very often that questions are asked. Now, when you see A part, when I am talking about most important part, you will find almost in all the exam papers or revision test papers, these chapters are tested upon. When you're talking about B part, they are asked once in two attempts, right? So, time of supply is one such case. Assessment and audit, repeatedly asked question, different types of audits or different types of assessment, explain them, assessment and audits are. Appeals and revision, in appeals and revision, importantly, they talk about your pre-deposit. Importantly, they touch upon your concept of pre-deposit and interest on pre-deposit. E-bill, once in a while it is asked, which means that out of two papers, you will find one paper discussing about your E-bill, right? And friends, when you are talking about your documentation chapter, in documentation chapter, not entire documentation is it's covered by B part. It is tax invoice, bill of supply, revised tax invoice, debit note, credit note and due date of invoice. The other documentation like your receipt voucher, refund voucher, self-invoice, payment voucher, common points, etc. All of them is covered in C part, residuary points. Importantly, you have to focus on your repeatedly asked questions are from your tax invoice, bill of supply, revised tax invoice, credit note, debit note and due date of invoice. Section 31, due date of invoice. What is the time limit for raising the invoice for supply of goods and for supply of services? That will be part of a another question. It will not be asked separately, it will be part of another question. And friends, your basic topic GS in India, right? From that rarely questions are asked, but whenever questions are asked from that area in one mark format, they are only from subsuming of taxes, old taxes subsumed inside GST, which taxes are inside GST, which taxes are still outside the GST, and about article 246A, 269A, 279A. You are talking about introduction of GST, article 246A, 269A. Only parliament having certain powers with respect to making laws, 279A, your GST council. Then friends, your advance ruling, again, there are areas where simple questions are asked on advance ruling and you require very less time to revise your advance ruling. Likewise, job worker, you find that in one out of two or three exam papers, you find questions on advance ruling, job worker, which are very simple to revise. And friends, levy of GST, though it is the foundation of your GST, right, I have given it in B part, right, because questions are asked as a part of other questions. Say for example, you cannot find a question paper without the concept of composite supply and mixed supply. Though it is given in your classification chapter, it has got something to do with levy also. So when I am talking about levy of GST, including the concept of composite supply and mixed supply, take your revision test paper or exam paper or mock test paper. There cannot be any question paper without discussion about composite supply or mixed supply, right? About supply, at times it is asked, at times it is not asked. Whether it is supply or deemed supply or not supply, it is not sure that you will get in a paper, exam paper. But about composite supply, mixed supply, with surety you will get it for sure. Offences and penalties, I have just given in B part, but I have to tell one point for sure. Offences and penalties always as a question, but you may tell that what it is given in B part, because it is more about remembering the amounts. So I don't want you to spend more time on offences and penalties. Okay, if at all it is coming in MCQs, you should be very clear with the options and you may go by with elimination policy and find out the correct answer. So give priority, but after going through all these chapters. Do we find a question on offences and penalties always in a question paper? Answer is yes. But when you talk about that chapter, it is more about by-hearting or mugging the amounts, not about conceptually understanding anything, right? So that being the case, if at all you have done through all the areas of A, most important chapters, B, important chapters, finally you just focus on your offences and penalties, right? Now friends, when you talk about the C part, least important part, right, your written filing chapter, right, though it is a very simple chapter, very rarely asked written filing chapter, liability to pay in certain cases, very rarely it is asked. But when you once you go through, you'll find that things are very simple. TDS, TCS, again, very rarely it is asked, right? But I will tell that when you are talking about the C part, don't skip. They will be clubbed with some other questions. Say, for example, in this RTP, we are going to discuss the first MCQ, which is about your TCS. So you have to go through it. It requires very less time. So once you're done with your A and B part, make sure that you walk through. Now, what is walk through? Go through it. You have studied it thoroughly. Now, just turn the pages and go through it. Okay. Key points try to remember. Eco, electronic commerce operator. Accounts and records very, very rarely asked. At least when you talk about your return filing, TDS, TCS, liability to pay in certain cases, make sure that you just walk through it surely. Eco, very rarely asked. Accounts and records, very rarely asked. GST in India. Residue points. Apart from your subsuming of taxes in Article 246A, 279A, 269A, other points, just very rarely asked. Just keep it in the end. And like, just like that, you're talking about your classification, other entries of exemption apart from the important entries that you have discussed in A part, government, education, healthcare, other residuary exemptions, give least priority. Inspection, search, seizure, arrest, questions are asked, give least priority. Miscellaneous provisions, hardly once it is asked, so don't give much importance to that particular area. And in C part, I will reiterate that. At least give due focus on the first three areas. Walk through for the first three areas for sure. Just walk through. You need not be having everything in your mind with surety, but walk through your return filing area, which is very small. When you revise return filing in a summary, which is given in the summary chart before, I mean, in the beginning of return filing chapter, or TDS TCS, which is given by way of differentiation chart, hardly 4 or 5 pages. Go through it. Right. That is all about your ABC analysis of your GST. Now, friends, when you talk about your ABC analysis of customs, I need not rather try to tell anything. If you refer our material, around 15 chapters are there in customs. So, I have given this ABC analysis from our material point of view, not from ICA chapters. But when you club ICA chapters, you can easily understand what these, if at all you have referred ICA material, you can easily understand from which area that is covered. Right, when you talk about your customs, needless to tell, the most important area is valuation. Including relevant date, exchange rate and rate of duty, relevant date, valuation along with your relevant date, which are given in two separate chapters. Relevant date is a very small chapter. You're talking about your valuation. Basic concepts. Basic concepts will cover your product, process and place. That is your goods, meaning of import, export and meaning of place, India, and your customs frontier of India. So that is covered in basic concepts. And next important area is charging section. Now, what is covered in charging section is not only section 12, special charging section, section 20, 21, and exception to charging section, the most important area where you are talking about pilferage, section 13, you are talking about damage and deterioration, abatement, section 22, you are talking about section 23.1, loss or destruction of goods, remission, section 23.2, relinquishment of title. Section 24, denaturing, mutilation. So all these are covered in charging section. Normal charging section, section 12. Special charging section, section 20, 21. Exception to charging section where you're talking about pilferage, section 13. Damage, deterioration, section 22. Section 23.1, remission for loss or destruction. Section 23.2, relinquishment of title. And section 24, denaturing, mutilation. That area you have to cover for sure. And needless to say, baggage. Rather, immediately after valuation, focus first on baggage. Thereafter, your duty drawback, where you're talking about practical questions. Practical questions mainly comes from your valuation, baggage and duty drawback. And case laws, I'm just cancelling this case laws because while discussing all the chapters, we have discussed case laws together. Along with the relevant chapters, we have discussed case laws together. So focus should be first given on your valuation, duty drawback, baggage, basic concepts and charging section. A part. Now, friends, next important thing that you have to focus is B, foreign trade policy. If at all time permits, focus on it. Otherwise, it is a very vast chapter. You know the important areas that are there. Practically, I mean, repeatedly asked questions from your mock test paper or revision test paper or exam paper. You know the important areas that practical questions are asked in MEIS or SEIS scheme, or you're talking about EPCG or advanced authorization. All those practical areas, at least walk through it. Right, but once you are done with other areas of B part, which means that once you are done with your types of duties, including anti-dumping duty, safeguard duty and anti-subsidizing duty, import procedure, not the entire import procedure, friends, I'm only talking about sections 46, 47 along with deferred payment. I'm not talking about the other theoretical portion. Only focus on section 46, filing of bill of entry, section 47, making the payment and clearing the goods, and deferred payment rules. Other areas of your import procedure, that is not so important, C part. That is not so important. When you're talking about import procedure, make sure that 46, 47 and deferred payment rules are surely gone through. And when I'm talking about the next area, audit and assessment, I'm not talking about entire audit and assessment, I'm focusing only on provisional assessment. The other area of audit and assessment, which is again very small, that I've given in your C part, residuary points. And friends, another area is refund. Now, I would suggest you to go through first your types of duties, import procedures, section 46, 47 and deferred payment, audit assessment, specifically provisional assessment and refund. Thereafter, take upon foreign trade policy, only important areas. Because exam day revision, you may not have time, entire time to go through entire foreign trade policy. Right. Make sure that if a question is asked from MCQs, you are able to attend it. And if at all you are not having time for going through foreign trade policy, don't worry, you may skip that question. But it is normally, if you see any exam paper, you'll find a question about your foreign trade policy. That is the reason it is given in B part. But take it in the end of B part. Now, other unimportant areas are classification of goods, where you talk about your tariff rate of duty or harmonized system of nomenclature, where you talk about your general interpretative rules. So that is not so important area. Transit and transshipment procedure, not so important area. Export procedure, not so important area. Right, rather, if you see the first part, valuation, basic concept, charging section, baggage and duty drawback, that itself, if at all, with respect to shortage of time, make sure that you focus on these areas for sure. And if you have some time left out for exam day revision, take upon your import procedure 46, 47, deferred payment first, provisional assessment next, refund next. Thereafter, if you have some time, your types of duties and foreign trade policy. Go with this particular sequence. Right, that is all about your ABC analysis when you talk about your exam day revision for your customs.